In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a seamless zoom transition like this, where one clip zooms right through into the next in Adobe Premiere Pro. Let's dive in. I've got three clips in the timeline here with just straight cuts between each clip. We'll move the playhead to the cut point between the first two clips and zoom in a little. We're going to create this transition using adjustment layers. Head over to the project window, click New Item, Adjustment Layer, hit OK, and then drag that adjustment layer over to a track above the cut point between the two clips. Hold Shift on your keyboard and hit the left arrow key three times to move 15 frames to the left of the breakpoint between clips, and trim the adjustment layer down to there. Go 15 frames to the right of the cut and do the same. Then hit C on the keyboard to select the razor tool and cut the adjustment layer right in the center so the cut lines up with the one between video clips. Hit V on the keyboard to go back to the selection tool, and we'll start with the first half of the transition, zooming in as we leave the first clip. Select the first adjustment layer, go to Effects, search for the Transform effect, and since the adjustment layer is already selected, we can just double-click on the Transform effect to add it to the layer. Then, in the Effect Controls window, within that Transform effect, click the stopwatch beside Scale to create a keyframe. Move forward to the second to last frame of the adjustment layer and type in 200 for the scale value, which will add another keyframe. We're doubling the scale as we transition out of this clip, but at this point the animation is linear. It scales up at the same speed the whole way through. We want to add some acceleration here. Start slow and increase in speed as we near the cut point between clips. So select both keyframes, right-click and click Ease In, right-click again and click Ease Out. Then grab the control handles below each keyframe and drag them all the way to the right. Now we've got this nice velocity curve here and our zoom will accelerate into the cut point. You can drag the second keyframe all the way to the end now. We're done with keyframes. And we can add motion blur by unchecking Use Compositions Shutter Angle and setting the shutter angle to 360. That's the max. You can try less, 180 or 270, depending on what works best for your footage. But 360 works well for my clips. So now you can see, if I go frame by frame here, that we've added some motion blur that increases as the velocity increases. And this zoom in effect now looks much smoother and much more dynamic than before. All right, so that's the first half of this transition. Now for the second half of the transition, there's a problem. We don't want to start at 100% scale and zoom in from there. We want to finish at 100%, but we can't begin the transition at less than the frame size. Otherwise, we end up with all this blank space. So what do we do? I'm glad you asked. We're going to create a bit of an optical illusion here. Before we do any zooming in, we're going to add a couple other effects to the second adjustment layer. So select it, go back to the effects window, and search for Replicate. Double-click that to add it to the layer. And up in the Effect Controls window, change the count to 3. So now we have this 9-panel version of the original clip, with one in the center that we'll eventually zoom into. But we have these hard edges where each of these clones meet. So we're going to use another effect to make this look like one big seamless image. Go back to Effects, type in Mirror, and with the adjustment layer still selected, double-click the Mirror effect 4 times. You heard me right, 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. And in the Effect Controls window, you should now see 4 instances of that effect. We'll start with the first one, change the reflection angle to 90 degrees, and right above that we have the horizontal and vertical values, X and Y, for the reflection center. We're going to adjust the Y value here until there's no space or overlap between these two slices, until they line up seamlessly. If you find it hard to see the edges, you can always zoom in a little. It might take a little finessing to get it exact. And now we've gotten rid of one of the seams between the images. We just need to repeat this process for each of the other seams. So let's go to the second mirror effect, and this time change the reflection angle to minus 90, and then adjust the Y value until that one lines up. So we've gotten rid of both horizontal seams, now we'll take care of the vertical ones. In the third mirror instance, set the reflection angle to 180, and don't worry if everything seems to have disappeared for a moment. This time we'll adjust the X value, drag that to the left, and line this up so there's no gap here. And then with the final mirror effect, we can leave the reflection angle at 0. Just drag the X value to the left until those edges meet, and the last seam disappears. So now we've got this one big, seamless image with no hard edges, and a clean, borderless copy of the original clip smack dab in the center. Now we can add the transform effect to this adjustment layer, but with a couple minor differences. Just like before, click the stopwatch beside scale to create a keyframe, but this time set the value to 150. Move forward to the second to last frame, and set the scale to 300. And now we've got our full-sized image back. We animated the scale in the first clip from 100 to 200, basically doubling it. So we're doubling the scale on this clip as well, from 150 to 300. We'll add easing to this animation as well, so select both keyframes, right-click ease in, right-click ease out. But this time, instead of accelerating into the transition, we're going to decelerate out of it. So we're going to drag both those easing handles way over to the left this time. Now we can move the second keyframe to the end, and of course uncheck Use Composition's Shutter Angle and set the shutter angle to 360 to add that motion blur. So now we've got a smooth transition that zooms straight through one clip into the next. But wait, there's more. I'll show you how to make this already cool transition even better with one more simple step. We're going to add a little elasticity here, just a little finishing touch. Let's grab that first adjustment layer, hold down the Option key on a Mac or Alt if you're on a PC, and drag it up to the track above to make a copy. Stretch it out to the full length of the transition, go to the Effect Controls window and delete the Transform effect, and in the Effects window, search for Lens Distortion. Ignore these other distortion effects you're seeing here. These are from a plugin I've added. You want the one that's in Premiere Pro's Distort folder. Double-click that effect to add it to your new adjustment layer. And with that effect, we can change the curvature of our footage. So we're going to use this to add a bit of an elastic feel to this transition. Click the stopwatch beside curvature to add a keyframe at the beginning of the layer, add another keyframe in the middle, and one at the end. Go to the middle keyframe and set the curvature there to minus 30. You can play around with this value depending on how elastic-y you want your transition to look. I like minus 30. It's enough to make a noticeable difference, but not completely over the top. And once again, we're going to add some easing here. Select all three keyframes, right-click ease in, right-click ease out, and this time we'll drag all the keyframe handles towards the middle, creating this curved V-shape with the velocity graph. And now we have this cool frame-bending, elastic-y feel to the transition. I'll hide the second track so you can see this a bit better. The first clip kind of slingshots into the next. If you want to copy this transition to another cut, just select all the adjustment layers, hold down Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC, and drag them over to where the cut points line up. And there you go. If you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a nice comment.